Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to today's webinar on Health is Wealth, a dieting tips by Professor Rekha Divekar ma'am. This session is being organized by Master Judicial Academy along with Professor Rekha Divekar ma'am in collaboration with SSC Online. As we say that, you know, it is always better to share knowledge when it is required, when it's needed. So in today's era when everyone is working from home and I always tell you that either people are losing a lot of weight or they're gaining a lot of weight. So there's no balance in between. So I think I'm really thankful to Master Judicial Academy, and I think I can talk on behalf of Master Judicial Academy that keeping in mind what is necessary and bringing that on board is really, really important. On this panel, we have Dr. Yellagara sir, who's a joint director of Master Judicial Academy and a very active member. And I think the main member who has been after all these behind all these webinars and success of these webinars. And we have Professor Rekha ma'am as well. Without any further ado, I will pass the baton to Yellagara sir. But before that, just a few things to be there, keep a note of. We will have questions, as we all know that this is a session wherein the speaker speaks, and in the last leg of the session, we take questions. The questions are being deactivated right now, so you cannot ask questions. However, after 30 minutes from this session, that is at 4:30, we'll open the question answer round. You can keep posting your questions, and once ma'am is done with the detailing, we'll take the question one by one. Sir, Yellagara sir, over to you, and I would request you to please introduce ma'am and welcome ma'am and take this forward. So over to you.
Thank you very much, Chetan Singh. It's my pleasure to welcome Professor Rekha Vinay Kumar Divekar. She is a MSc first class in organic chemistry. Apart from this, she is Sangeet Visharad also. She worked as lecturer in Sathe College, Ville Parle. Retired in 2010 after completing 35 years of service. Recently, she conducted workshops for Colgate Palmolive India, the Slimmest Waste and Fuller Life, and TomTom International, Evonik India Private Limited, and also for BARC, that is Baba Atomic Research Center, Mumbai Customs Officers, Police Academy Maharashtra, and a full day workshop on Stay Youthful Forever in Kavalyadham Yoga Institute, Mumbai. She also conducted programs, live program on Doordarshan DD Sahyadri, that is a Marathi channel, on New Year resolutions to keep fit, and Talk in Marathi Vishwa, New Jersey, on chemistry in the kitchen. Similarly, Talk in Nairobi and Nakuru, Kenya, on chemistry in the kitchen, and Anti-Aging Secrets. Talk for Sakhi Group in Birmingham, UK. Live radio show on EBC Radio in New Jersey, USA. Brahman Seva Mandal on Sundar Mi Hunar for Vadhuvar Melawa. And Doctors Katta at Nashik. Apart from these programs, ma'am has herself written articles relating to food in Kal Nirnay, which is a very famous calendar in Marathi. Ami Parlekar, Mukhyadapakanchi Diary, magazines dedicated to Ayurveda, special Diwali Ank by Maharashtra State Government. I will read some books. Names: Women and Weight Loss Tamasha by Ruzuta Dibekar. The Complete Guide to Becoming Pregnant by Dr. Feruza Parekh. The Land of Flying Llamas by Gaurav Punj. Don't Lose Out, Work Out by Ruzuta Divekar. Indian Superfoods by Ruzuta Divekar. Compiled Fitness Police Answer by Ruzuta Divekar. Pregnancy Notes by Ruzuta Divekar. You must be wondering why I'm taking the name of Ruzuta Divekar while we are having the guest of Rekha Divekar ma'am. Today's guest is mother of Ruzuta Divekar, and both are consultants not only for the general public, for VIPs, especially film industry, very well known figures both are. and ma'am has been practicing yoga for 30 years. You can see it. And ma'am has organic farming at Sonave near Safle, just outside Mumbai. This is an introduction from her side, an introduction from our Maharashtra Judicial Academy. Ma'am has been a guest faculty since I know, at least since 2014. She has been visiting, and she conducted sessions for our newly inducted judges as well as the working judges. And her tips were very, very useful, and they are very useful for especially for judges who have all types of complications physically and mentally also. And I welcome ma'am, Professor Rekha Vinay Kumar Divekar ma'am. It's my pleasure to welcome you virtually, though not physically. It would have been very nice, but yeah, at the same time it will be very nice to know that this webinar is being attended by many participants, many judicial officers and their families across India, right from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. I can say many judicial officers and their families are attending. And in the beginning itself, I welcome all of you participants, honorable my brother and sister judges and their families. Ma'am will give tips to the family members also, without taking much time. I express my first thanks to our honorable director and honorable chief justice for allowing us to conduct this kind of workshops, not only on the academics but on the health issues also. Thank you very much, ma'am. Please, I request you to start the session.
Thank you, sir. I'm also very happy that I'm getting this opportunity to talk to judges all over India, though I have talked in your academy for a limited number of judges. So there is something great here that I can contact many of the judges. So again, we will not waste time in these talks, but I will directly start with my topic. So actually, I will first talk about the issues that judges have to face. Now, the main problem is judges have to sit continuously, and therefore there are problems which are related to sitting, because it is said that sitting is new smoking only. That is, because of smoking, what are the issues which arise? Like blood pressure, diabetes, or heart issues. Similar issues arise due to continuous sitting. And therefore, we have to see what we can do to avoid these types of problems, which are called as non-communicable diseases, NCDs. Now, what are non-communicable diseases? Because we are now having this pandemic all over, we are in the fear of getting infected. But why this fear is there? Because this particular disease, coronavirus disease, this particular disease is not included in NCDs, non-communicable diseases, but it is communicable diseases. I will explain you this. Suppose someone is having blood pressure or diabetes. If we stay with that person, we are not going to get affected because of that person's blood pressure or diabetes. We will not get that disease. But if we come into contact with, say, a person who is having corona disease, not even the person, whatever he has touched, even the lift button, even the paper and whatever it may be, there is a chance that we will catch the disease. So this is communicable disease, coronavirus, while these diseases are non-communicable diseases, which the judges are more prone to normally. So let us first concentrate on these NCDs, that is what you must have in your diet to keep away from these NCDs, that is blood pressure, etc. And the another I will not say that it is an issue, but always you have to be mentally very alert. Even for 1 minute, your concentration should not get diverted to any other thing, but you have to listen very, very carefully. And if you have to listen very carefully, your brain should be very much alert. And therefore, to maintain this brain alertness, what you have to do, that also I will explain in the first part. And then, sir, as you said, I will proceed for the family members who may be suffering themselves or their relatives or neighbors, for whomever they want to help. So like this, we will divide this kind of two parts. So first, let us do it for judges especially. So the first thing that you have to remember is, because you are sitting continuously, you have to break that sitting part, which I know is not possible for you. You cannot just stand up in between. Otherwise, in the offices, we tell that, see, after 30 minutes of sitting, you should stand and you should do here and there. But for you, it is impossible. So what you must do is, at home only you have to do that, or whenever this unlocking, proper unlocking will take place, then only you can join the gym, etc. But right now at home, what you can do, that I will tell you first. First, regarding exercise, because it is a small part. See, in the morning before going to the court, you have to do at least 15 minutes of exercise. That is, I will tell you that the simplest is Surya Namaskars, because Surya Namaskars include many asanas in itself, and therefore doing this Surya Namaskars will help you a lot. Similarly, you can do squats also at home. And in the evening, what you can do is, you can just walk around. If you have a terrace or if you have a garden nearby, now depending upon how many people come over there, you have to take the chance of going there. But otherwise, at home also, it is possible to walk, because in this lockdown period, it is very much essential to keep yourself active, because otherwise, as Chetan sir has said, that it is likely that you will put on weight. So it should not happen. And therefore, now how to walk in home, I will tell you a simple trick. Suppose that you are having one hall, and in that hall, you just, instead of walking straightway, you just keep two chairs, okay, at two ends, and then you walk in the eight figures, like that you have to walk, like this. And when you walk like this, because the two chairs are there, you get the chance. Suppose you are at the center, go around the chair, and then you go around another chair. In this eight shape, if you keep on walking, what will happen is that we are, when we go out, we turn, we take a turn, and then again we take a turn, then we walk for straight for some time. So like that, this facility now we have to create in our own homes, because outside it is impossible. And if you have terrace, you must go in the terrace and walk. And if you are having many people around you, then you have to wear the mask. Otherwise, there is no necessity to wear the mask if there are very two, three, four people like we have in our terrace. So when you are walking in the terrace, what will happen is, you will be getting the fresh air also. क्योंकि हिंदी में एक कहावत है कि जो बात दवा से नहीं होती वो कभी कभी हवा से हो जाती है. एंड देयरफॉर टू गेट फ्रेश एयर इज सो मच इसेंशियल दैट एक्चुअली वी आर मिसिंग इट आउट राइट नाउ. सो यू हैव टू कैरी आउट बोथ दिस थिंग्स वेरी रिलीजियसली. इन द मॉर्निंग डू सूर्य नमस्कार, एंड इन द इवनिंग यू हैव टू डू वॉकिंग if available in the terrace. Otherwise, in the home only, you have to create the path and walk accordingly. So when unlocking will take place, of course I will ask you to join the gym and do the necessary weight training exercises, etc. But right now this is only the option. So what will happen because of the exercise? Now first let me talk about brain, because brain अलर्ट रहना बहुत जरूरी है आपके लिए. सो फॉर दैट ब्रेन रिक्वायर्स थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स. एंड व्हाट आर दिस थ्री थिंग्स? इट शुड गेट ऑक्सीजन, इट शुड गेट ग्लूकोज कंटिन्यूअसली, एंड इट शुड गेट वॉटर ऑल्सो continuously. So what Chetan sir is doing now, sipping water in between, so he wants to keep the brain alert. So I have also having this glass besides me, and I will also sip in between, because when you want that your brain is alert, you need these three things. And when oxygenation of brain takes place, only when you are exercise, I mean it will increase when you exercise, when you do Surya Namaskars, when you do walking, when you jog, when you swim, all these times oxygenation of brain will take place. Hydration, brain requires water also for its working. So pani peena bhi bahut jaruri hai. And the third thing, glucose. Now glucose means what? Whatever we are eating, after digestion it gets converted into glucose. So we should have continuous supply of glucose to the brain. It should not stop in between. So remember, these three things are necessary to keep our brain, our mind alert, and these are oxygen, water and glucose. Okay, so now you know what is to be done for oxygen, exercise. You know what is to be done for water, keep yourself hydrated, keep on sipping water, keep on having sherbets, etc. And then for nutrients, now let us see what we have to do so that we will have continuous supply of glucose to the brain. Okay, so let us see what are the things that you must include in your diet. Now the first and the foremost is ghee. Now why ghee is so important? Because we think that by eating fats we are going to become fat, but that is not the case nowadays. Because 40 years back, Western countries, they have declared that all saturated fats are bad for health. We have stopped consuming ghee. But then, I think 4 or 5 years back, they again said that we were completely wrong when we said that all saturated fats are bad for health. But in fact, some fats, some saturated fats are very good for health, and one of them is ghee. So ghee is very good fat. Why? Because it contains short chain fatty acids, one particular molecule, because of which it will not get accumulated in the body, but it will help the fat to burn, in fact. So it is other way around. It is not going to give us more weight on our body, but it will help in fat burning also. And now why I said that ghee is the foremost, because in our brain 60% fat cells are present, and therefore in our culture there is a practice of giving ghee ke laddu, I mean ghee dal ke jo laddus banate hain, methi ke laddus hai, gond ke laddu hai, methi ke laddu hai, sab mein bahut sara ghee jata hai, and which is given to the young mothers, and during pregnancy also this ghee is given. Why it is given? Because through the breast milk, the ghee, I mean the good quality fat, will reach to the baby, and will reach to the baby means it will help for the brain development of the baby. And the brain development of the baby takes place during first year only to the maximum extent. And that is why it is really advisable to have ghee for newly delivered mothers. But for everyone, why ghee is important? We also want our brain to be very active. For judges also, it is very essential for the brain to be very active and alert. So what they will need is the fat cells, the number of fat cells, which is about 60%. So this is very important quality of ghee. And the another most important thing is there are some vitamins. We always talk about vitamins. All are essential. We talk about vitamin D. Many people are suffering from vitamin D deficiency, etc. Actually, in India, we have good sunlight. However, if there is no good quality fat in our diet, then that D vitamin will not be getting assimilated in the body. See, normally what we say we are, what we eat. But actually, what I will like to say, we are what we digest and assimilate. Just eating is not sufficient. That eating, when whatever we have eaten, it should be digested, it should be assimilated. So if we want that vitamin D, which we get when we are going in out in the sunlight, we get it is in the form of D2. It gets converted into D3 for the body only in the presence of good quality fat. And therefore, ghee is very important. Now, not only vitamin D, but along with it, vitamin A, D, E, and K. All these four vitamins, they are fat-soluble vitamins. And only vitamin B and C are water-soluble vitamins. So, if you want also vitamin A to be assimilated in your body, you need ghee. And therefore, we always say in the movies, carrot, gajar ka halwa. Sirf aise gajar ke tukde karke sirf Western people or those who are on the fat diets, they eat just carrot. But in our movies or in our homes, what we make? Gajar ka halwa. Why we make gajar ka halwa? Because gajar will be assimilated in the body only in the presence of fat. Or we can make gajar ka, what we call as kachumbar, koshimbir, where we add singdana, peanuts, or we add coconut, etc. So again, some fat. So what I want to tell you is, what is the importance of ghee? Ghee's importance is for the assimilation of vitamins also. Okay, it is not just for brain, but it is for all vitamins also. It provides us a good lubrication for our joints. Because sitting continuously may give problems for the joints and in general for the spine. So to keep the joints supple also, we require ghee as for the lubrication. So I think this is enough for ghee, and I'm sure that all of you will start eating ghee. How much ghee? This question I always expect. So I'm answering right now. You can have 3 teaspoons of ghee, one with breakfast, one with lunch, and one with the dinner. Bindas, you can have it, and no need of worrying about the weight gain. Now let us come to the second important food, and especially for judges, again, curds. Chas, dahi, curd is very important for us. Now why curd is very important? Because it contains probiotic bacteria. Now I think everyone must be knowing about this probiotic bacteria, because these bacteria are present on all the navdwars, jo navadwar bolte hai, hamare body mein jo hai navdwars. So bacteria are present on all the navdwars, and they are actually useful bacteria. See, there are two types of bacteria. One is pathogenic bacteria. Pathogenic bacteria are those which are responsible for giving us diseases. And there are gut-friendly bacteria. What are gut-friendly bacteria? Gut-friendly bacteria are very much essential for our body. So when we say probiotic, bio is life and pro is for. So for life, probiotic bacteria are very much essential, and their strength, I mean their number as well as their varieties, will decide how much healthy you are. That much importance that probiotic bacteria is having, and the curd is having this probiotic bacteria. Not only curd, but all the sprouts, they also contain this bacteria, as well as whenever you are eating any fermented thing like idli hai, dhokla or dosa, so whenever you are carrying out fermentation process, there will be probiotic bacteria which are present in them. So because of this probiotic bacteria, how it will be helping us? See, it is said that it is as important as our heart, lungs, kidneys and brain. Like that, bacteria are very important. Now everyone must have experienced some or the other time in their life that if you have to take antibiotic, what is antibiotic? Against life. Probiotic is for life, antibiotic is against life. Now when we are taking antibiotics, what will happen is the medicine will act upon useful as well as pathogenic bacteria. And therefore doctors also advise us that you must take curds when you are taking antibiotics, or they will give some tablets which will be containing bacteria. And therefore the importance of this probiotic bacteria is so much that what is the main function of it? It helps in the delivery of nutrients to each and every part of our body. Nutrients can reach to each and every part of our body, means brain also, through these probiotic bacteria which are present. I mean they help in that process. And therefore the importance of curd is extremely great. And remember, you should never buy packaged curd assuming that it is helping me for my probiotic bacteria. Why? Because the growth of bacteria there in the packaged dahi, it is stopped, and we are getting the curd in which there will not be proliferation, or the bacteria which are present in that curd, they are not going to multiply. Otherwise, when you make homemade curd, what happens? It turns sour after some time. Suppose you keep it outside, you don't keep it in the fridge, then what will happen? It turns sour, and then some people like it, some people don't like it. Some people will convert it into kadhi or dhokla or something of that sort. Okay, but what is important is the bacteria must multiply. Then only it is useful for us. And therefore, I will request all the family members are also there, as sir said, that make it a practice of making curd every day for evening as well as for morning. Okay, so the second important for particularly judges and for everyone is this probiotic bacteria provider, which is a curd. Now I will proceed to the third food material, which is again very important for our brain, and that is inclusion of millets in our diet. So what are millets? Jawar, bajra, ragi. All these are millets. Now what are these millets? Now the millets, they contain complex carbohydrates. Along with the complex carbohydrates, they contain many vitamins, minerals, as well as fiber. Now, whenever there is complex carbohydrate, what happens is the process of digestion, it will take place for a more time, and what will happen is the glucose is released in the blood slowly but continuously. When we are having simple carbohydrates, like suppose that you are eating some pastry, if you are eating some cake, then what will happen? the blood sugar will immediately rise. But if you are eating jawar ka roti, bajra ka roti, ragi ka roti, then blood sugar will not rise immediately and suddenly, but blood sugar will be remaining almost the same. That is, there will be continuous but slow release of sugar in the blood. Now, when there is slow and continuous release of blood sugar, what will happen? Our brain is also getting this particular glucose continuously. Okay, because what is the final product of the digestion of all these rotis and all? Glucose only. So brain needs glucose, and therefore it is advisable to eat millets, because then what is the another advantage that you people will get? There is no chance of having blood pressure, diabetes, etc. also if you consume these millets, because they contain fiber also and they contain minerals also, vitamins also. So all this will help you to keep away from non-communicable diseases. At the same time, they will keep providing glucose continuously to the brain, and I'm sure which will be helping you. So what you must do, that you can carry a ragi ka laddu with you when you go to the court. So once you eat that ragi ka laddu, Sudhakar sir knows that I have always mentioned this, and many ladies over there, many judges were there, ladies, and they asked me the recipes also of these ragi ka laddus. I hope they are doing cooking it now also. So this ragi ka laddu will help you in having your brain alert, and you will not feel hungry also very soon. Just because I am talking about this, I would like to tell you that I am on Instagram, and there I write all these important recipes, traditional recipes, in the name of Rekha Divekar only. So those who are on Instagram, they can follow me and look for all these recipes. So this is about the three main food materials which you must have: ghee, curd, and different millets at different times whenever suits you. Because everyone's, I think, the timings are also different. So I cannot say that you eat it in the morning or in the evening or afternoon. Whenever it is possible, you should have millets in your diet. So now let us proceed to our second part, which is regarding the pandemic now. Now, what has happened is because of this coronavirus, immunity has become the catchphrase. Everyone is talking about immunity, but immunity is not the thing which will be developing overnight. Chalo, aaj turmeric kha liya, turmeric latte le liya, and my immunity increases. It is not going to increase in one day. But I think that it is better to be late than never, that all of us are now aware of immunity. ये कोरोना आज है, कल नहीं होगा, कल उसके भाई बहन भी हो सकते हैं, नहीं भी हो सकते हैं, बट वी हैव टू बी ऑलवेज अलर्ट दैट अवर इम्यूनिटी इज एट इट्स बेस्ट. सो इफ वी वॉन्ट अवर इम्यूनिटी एट इट्स बेस्ट, एंड आई एम श्योर दैट एज सर हैज इन्फॉर्म मी, देर आर मे बी people who have recovered also from corona, some people have their relatives having this problem. So what are the things that you have to include so that your immunity will remain strong? So now I will talk about that. So first of all, I will like to tell you that there are various nutrients, and all the nutrients are required by the body. It is not that you have just 3-4 nutrients, powerful nutrients, and you will be fine. It is not like that. It is like electric board. So all the wiring should be perfect, then only it will go on smoothly. So like that, we need all the nutrients. However, there are certain nutrients which play tremendous part in maintaining the immunity. Now, what are these four nutrients? I can say that these are the pillars, four pillars of immunity, and those nutrients are iron, zinc, then proteins, iron, zinc, proteins, and vitamin C. Now, all of you are aware of vitamin C. Everyone is talking about vitamin C, that have nimbu sharbat. In fact, yesterday evening I went to the market and there was no lemon in the market. All lemons in the morning only, lemons are over. Because now everyone wants immunity. So all of you know that lemon is a very good source of vitamin C. But the greatest and the best source is amla, gooseberry. Now, why this is the best source? Because you can cook the amla, you can dry the amla, you can store the amla, and the vitamin C is not getting reduced, is not getting diminished by any of the processes. It will remain intact. However, if you consider vitamin C from lemon, if you heat, if you add to some say vegetable or poha or upma and you heat, then vitamin C level will decrease from that the food material, because heating affects the quantity of vitamin C. But if you are heating amla, then vitamin C levels will not decrease. Why? Because it contains one particular chemical called as gallic acid. So it will prevent the decomposition of vitamin C, and therefore you will get good vitamin C if you have amla. If you are not getting lemon in the market, you can very easily opt for this amla, and you can get it in the form of chyawanprash. That also now you have to search, because everyone is having now this chyawanprash also. So this is very important, because vitamin C gives us immunity to a great extent. So try to have vitamin C. Then I will talk about now proteins. Now, because why proteins are important? Because whenever you are also hearing about now antibodies test, if somebody is found to have antibodies, it means that the person has already suffered from corona, but maybe asymptomatic, and therefore it is not revealed. And after the antibodies test is done, it is observed that the person had the corona, but to the lesser extent, and the person has good immunity, and therefore the antibodies are produced. So how the antibodies are produced? Antibodies production is possible only with proteins. And therefore, proteins, if there are no proteins, sufficient proteins in your diet, there will not be sufficient amino acids. Now I will talk in 2-3 lines about amino acids. Proteins jo hai wo amino acids se bante hain. So from whatever proteins we are eating, they are converted into amino acids. And then from these amino acids, we get the different proteins required for by the body. It is like we have alphabets. Now we have very less number of alphabets, 26, but how many words are formed? We don't know. Lakhs of words are possible just by different permutations, combinations of the alphabets. Similarly, by the different combinations, permutations of these amino acids, we can have lots of proteins which are required by the body, and antibodies are also these types of proteins. And therefore, it is very essential to have sufficient quantity of proteins in our diet. Now, how can you get sufficient quantity of proteins in your diet? In our culture, the system already exists. See, in North India, normally, rajma chawal, is eaten. In South India, they eat idli, which is again rice and udad dal combination. In Maharashtra, we eat dal chawal, which is tuar dal or moong dal or masoor dal, anything. So there is a combination of rice with some dal everywhere in India. Now, why this combination is there? Does it mean when I say that you should have protein, does it mean that you don't eat rice and just eat dals? No, it is not like that, because rice also contains some amino acids, which is a part of protein. And dals also contain proteins or amino acids which are not there in the rice. And therefore, the combination works well. What I don't have, that the another person will be having. So like that, it makes the complete amino acid profile when you have rice along with dal. So everywhere you will see that these combinations exist, as I explained you, and therefore you must keep that practice intact and don't just go on having only dal or only sprouts. It is not going to help. Only when you eat complete rice, dal along with ghee and lemon, etc., then only you will be getting all the nutrients which are required by the body. Okay, so proteins are of great importance. You will get them from different pulses, different sprouts, and then you are also getting them from milk and milk products. That is from milk, curd, paneer, cheese, all of them will be having the proteins, different types of amino acids. So like this, you have to keep having the proteins also in your diet daily. Now I will proceed to, after vitamin C and proteins, let us talk about zinc and then iron also. Now let me talk about iron first. Now, how iron helps? All of us know that when we have iron in our diet, then only hemoglobin will be formed in sufficient amount. When hemoglobin is formed, hemoglobin combines with oxygen, oxyhemoglobin is formed, and then oxyhemoglobin has the ability to deliver oxygen as well as nutrients to each and every part of our body. And if you are having less of hemoglobin, then what will happen? You will be having anemia, and this particular disease is especially respiratory disease. Those who are having already respiratory issues, they are likely to get this problem. And therefore, it is very essential that the iron in our body, that is hemoglobin content, should be proper. Now, if we want hemoglobin to be proper, then what you must do, one thing which is the very simple and must do, is cook in iron kadai. Now, if cooking in iron kadai, if you find it difficult, because not difficult, but the color of the vegetable changes and therefore many people don't like it. So what you can do is, at least you can make your roti, thepla, paratha, dosa, chilla, ghavan, dhirda, whatever you are making on tawa, whatever tawa item you are doing, that must be done on iron tawa. If you do this, if you keep this practice, then you will be getting your daily dose of iron. I mean, some part at least, through just by using iron vessels. So use of iron vessels is very essential. And then what are the different iron sources from the food that I will like to tell you. So what you must do is, nowadays especially, soak overnight black raisins. Okay, about 7 to 8 black raisins you take, soak them in water at night along with one or two stripes of kesar, and in the morning have those along with the water. So these black resins will be providing you iron. Along with that, in the day, what you must eat is, as I said, millets are very good. They also contain lot of iron. Ragi also contains lot of iron. Then moringa. Moringa jo hai, that is drumsticks. Our Prime Minister also day before yesterday mentioned about moringa parathas. So that is a very good source of iron also. So this moringa leaves also you should use, because not only just drumsticks, but moringa leaves contain more of iron. So you can make vegetable out of it. You can add those leaves to the chila, to the rotla, to the bhakri, whatever you are preparing. But use those leaves. Along with that, you have to also use whatever green vegetables you are getting in the season. See, what we always think that we must eat palak daily, or we have to eat methi daily. It is not necessary. Any green vegetable is good, but that vegetable should be seasonal. Particularly in the rainy season, there are many green vegetables which you get only now, and they just last for about 8 days to maximum 1 month. And at that time, you must have those green vegetables rather than running after palak and methi daily. Why? Because they contain some nutrients which we may not be knowing also, because that way this nutrition science is not very old. It is comparatively new science, and there may be some nutrients which are still not discovered also. But always our nannies and dadis have said that this particular vegetable you should have, so that for the whole year you will not get any disease. That is what our nannies have told us. So that there is a science behind it, that in this season. Now, have you heard about ambadi, which is a khatti vegetable jo hoti hai? You must have heard. So now, why this vegetable is good now? Because otherwise other vegetables, green vegetables, if you are planting and trying to having them, then there is a growth of bacteria. Right now in this particular rainy season, there are many bacteria which are growing on these vegetables. But because of that sourness of ambadi vegetable, bacteria will not grow on it, and therefore it is good for us. The same thing is true with aluchi bhaji, what in Marathi we call colocasia. Marathi alu, and English mein colocasia leaves, jiske Gujarati people jo alu vadi banate hai. So that is also very good, because on that also there will not be any bacteria growth. Because again, it gives, if you don't add imli to it, then it gives kharash to our throat. Khau khau jo bolte hai na, scratching jaise hota hai. So we must add imli, otherwise you cannot eat it. So similarly, bacteria will also not grow on that particular vegetable because of that particular itchiness that the plant is giving. So these vegetables are very important for not only increasing iron, but for other unknown nutrients, maybe we can say, but we must have them seasonally. Whatever you get in the season, you should have. So right now, we call them as ran bhaja, that is uncultivated vegetables. We have not cultivated, but they come of their own from the nature, automatic plants, as our grandchildren call them. They are automatic plants. We have not done anything to grow them. So those plants you have to use. Okay, so this is for your iron. Use all the green vegetables, use all the dark color jitna millet mein hoga utna aapke liye wo acha hoga. Similarly, pomegranate, all these dark colored fruits also, they contain iron. So this is for iron. Now I will proceed for zinc, which is the next mineral that you should be having. So where you get zinc? Now actually zinc is present again in all the millets also, and in many pulses also it is present, particularly in the pulses like rajma and chole and chawli. All these, they will contain more of zinc, and all the dry fruits. And therefore, when I told you that in the morning you have black raisins, along with it, you should have some dry fruit. Like you can have almond, about 4 to 5 almonds, again soak overnight. In the morning, remove the skin and have it. Now, why skin should be removed? Because they contain anti-nutrients. Now you have heard the word nutrient. Similarly, what is anti-nutrient? Which is not allowing the nutrient to be assimilated in the body. So the skin of the almond will be containing anti-nutrients, and therefore it is advisable to remove the skin of almond. Or you can have pista or akrod, any dry fruits of your choice. You can have cashews also. So this is about zinc. That now dry fruits, now if you are having old people at home, what you must do is make the powder of it, and then you can give through milk, because otherwise those people are having problem that I cannot chew it properly. So grind it in the mixer and then add it to the milk, and they can have it. But everyone must have these dry fruits during this at particular time of pandemic for zinc. And again, all the different millets and pulses. And again, one more important instruction from the kitchen: don't use aluminium vessel. Now, why don't use aluminium vessel? Because when we eat the food which is cooked in the aluminium vessel, what will happen? Aluminium will be added to the food material. Aluminium will go in our digestive system, and aluminium displaces zinc from our body. It will remove zinc and takes its place, and we become zinc deficient. If we become zinc deficient, then our immunity system collapses, literally. And not only just for immunity system, but zinc is very much required for our insulin sensitivity. So what is insulin sensitivity? Which will be allowing our insulin to work well, and we will not be having any chance of having diabetes. Similarly, it helps for maintaining hormonal balance also, for all the other hormones also. Okay, so this is about zinc. So these are the four pillars. I don't mean that other nutrients are not required. They are also required, but these are the pillars. Now, some few things I will like to add. You should have, as I said, amla to compulsory daily lena hai. And another thing, turmeric you must have. Now, how you should have turmeric? You should not take curcumin tablets. Many people nowadays are taking curcumin. What is curcumin? Curcumin is present in turmeric powder. I mean, the curcumin is the active part from the haldi. So people are taking those tablets, but they are not going to help. You should have haldi in a way which you are having culturally. That is, we add in the tadka, we add in the sabji, we add in the curry. We make achar out of raw haldi, or we can have turmeric milk at night. Okay, so turmeric you should be having in this particular period. And another thing is ginger. Ginger or sunt powder. It is having so much importance that it is called as Vishwaushadhi. Vishwaushadhi, so that it is required by everyone. So it may be in the form of fresh ginger, or it may be in the form of dry sunt powder. So it will be giving you relief from respiratory diseases, digestive problems, for joint issues. For judges also, I will say that daily you should have this ginger in some or the other form. I mean, not only for pandemic, but continuously. Turmeric, ginger, all these are very important things. Now, I think that this is all that I wanted to tell you, that all the nutrients are required, exercise is a must, and then you have to keep your calm. You should not get continuously, you should not be under tension that what will happen if I get. There are many people now, all of us know that they are undergoing depression and all that. So what I will tell, I will end it with one line, which is again Hindi mein jo ek kahawat hai, paav garam. Paav garam matlab keep active, you should be active continuously. Paav garam, pet naram. Pet naram means you should never overeat. Eat according to your hunger. Don't be under someone's pressure to eat extra. If you go to somebody's place, then somebody will say that abhi itna khao aur thoda sa khao, to aise mat aana kisi ke pressure mein. Paav garam, pet naram, aur sar ho jiska thanda. To sar thanda rehna chahiye. Then doctor bhi yadi aaye to marenge unko danda. To hame matlab hai ki doctor hi nahi lagega. So we have to keep our paav garam, pet naram, or sar thanda, and that's it. Thanks a lot. Now you can ask me the questions.
What a session, ma'am. What a wonderful session.
Thank you, sir.
I think Yelagra sir or me, we were just nodding and we were just making notes. I'm sure everyone who attended the session had the same things to take. Yelagra sir, anything that you want to add before we get to the question answer round? Your mic is muted, sir. Yeah. Sir, we can't hear you. I think your mic, your earphones mic is not working.
No, I think I'm audible.
Yes,
now.
Yes.
Just as I was remembering, ma'am, you said that about that Ambadi.
Yeah.
Let me tell you that Ambadi in Andhra, in Telugu, it is known as in literature, Andhra Mata, means mother. For Andhra Mata. Yeah, it is called Gongura, and we call it as Andhra Mata. This the designation, the respect to the people have given it.
So it is that much important.
Yes. So just and same thing with that our Aluchi Bhaji also, same in Maharashtra, same status we have given.
Yes.
Yes, please Chetan, please sure. Take up the questions.
Sure, sir. The first question, like we were talking about the oils and ghee. So the question is, which edible oil is good for health?
Wherever you are staying, local oil is good for you. Now, if you are staying in Maharashtra, Gujarat, we get peanuts over here. So for us, Singdana oil is the best. The reason being the atmosphere here, whatever is the weather over here, it is suitable for peanuts. And in the same weather we are staying, so logically that peanut is only suitable for us. And therefore it is the practice of having peanut oil here. If you go to south, coconut oil, because lots of coconut trees there. And when you go to North India, you get sarso ka tel. So it is like that, local oil. It is, if you go to Italy, olive oil.
Chetan, you should prefer then sarso ka tel.
Yeah.
I think, to be honest, when ma'am was saying about ghee, my mom and dad are, they're very closely related to nature. So they read a lot and they still follow the old, tradition of cooking and everything. So when I was listening to ma'am, when ma'am said ghee, I was like, I know it, because I read it few years back that they were people who had ghee diet and they lost weight. So I was totally agreeing with you, and I like, I know this. So yeah, so for me, sarson tel and ghee any day.
Yes.
Next question, ma'am. It's about the sleeping pattern. So how, you know, probably I think I'll read the question for you. The question is, the person is 40 years old right now. The sleeping pattern is for only for 5 hours a day. That is between 12 to 5. Is it normal or not? And if it's not normal, which I think I will leave it to you, what tips you can suggest to have a better sleep, and for what duration that person should sleep?
Actually, required sleep is for everyone, it is different. Like hunger, everyone's hunger is different. Similarly, sleep also is different. But normally, it is from 6 hours to 8 hours for an adult. So he's getting 5 hours. So maybe he should have one more hour, and he should try to sleep early, because that will help more. Because all the processes, metabolic processes, they take place in a particular period. So not from some people. Nowadays, I always tell young generation that they sometimes sleep at 2 o'clock, and then in the morning they will, because of the lockdown, don't have to go out. So sleep at any time, wake up at any time, but it will disturb your biological clock. And therefore, it is necessary to stick to that particular routine of going to sleep at a particular time. And what that person must do is no gadgets, at least 1 to 2 hours before going to sleep. Then early dinner is advisable, so that when you go to sleep, most of the food is at least digested to half. Then the third important thing is, they can have cashew milk. If they are not getting good sleep, they can try to have cashew milk. Indian food wisdom, Rujuta Divekar's book, my daughter's book, she has mentioned about this cashew milk. So you can have that. And one more important thing you can do is, you can have that one kasha, what we call kasha chi vati. Sir, you must be knowing that particular metal is there, and you have to apply pure desi ghee on the soles of your feet before going to sleep, and then you will get good sleep. You can have nutmeg also, nutmeg in your milk, and when you are applying that ghee on the soles of your feet, you have to rub properly for some time. At least 10 minutes, then it will help.
Thank you.
Ma'am, there are a lot of people who, I think this is a very common question, that should we drink warm water or should we drink cold water?
You have to drink normal temperature water. Not, you don't have to heat it, but right now, yes, you can have warm water, but it is always better to have warm water rather than cold water. And in this pandemic time, so you should have warm water only, but otherwise, at least after lunch, after dinner, means after eating, when you are having water, see that particularly at that time, the water is warm. Otherwise, in between, when you have, you can have just room temperature water. But after lunch, after dinner, after breakfast, have lukewarm water.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, there's a question, but I think you've already answered, so I'm just going to quickly raise this question and answer it myself. The question is about that, should we, what is the right time to eat soaked almonds, and can soaked almonds be eaten with or without the skin? So like ma'am, you said that it should be soaked overnight and it should be without the skin. Ma'am, what was the word that you used? Antioxidant that they have, the skin has?
Anti-nutrient.
Anti-nutrient is on the skin, and that's why you should take it off. Now moving ahead, we were talking about various nutrients. We were talking about zinc, we were talking about iron. Now the question is that, like we hear a lot of time, there used to be a ad that Sunday ho ya Monday, roz khao ande, right? And so the question is on the same lines, that is egg recommended on a daily food during this pandemic?
those who are non-vegetarian, they can have. There is no problem in eating egg at all, but it is not necessary that vegetarian people have to leave that their vegetarian status and be non-vegetarian and have egg. That is not required. But if you are non-vegetarian, you should have non-veg as per your culture. Again, see what in our culture, those who are non-vegetarians, they are also taking only for few days. They are not taking non-veg daily, actually. But nowadays, because people want to be cool and then they can have it daily. So it is not advisable that way because it will not be getting digested. It requires more time for digestion and therefore that system was there. So at that time, ऐसे बोलते हैं ना कि कुछ भगवान का बोल के समझाओ तो वो टाइम ऐसा था तो इसलिए ये मंगलवार है इसलिए नहीं खाना थर्सडे इसलिए नहीं खाना आज ये गॉड का दिन है ऐसा सब था
Today I understood this concept, like why we say Tuesday and Thursday and Saturday, we should not eat. So,
because vegetarians also contain enough of proteins.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we would not have been there on the earth. We are strictly vegetarians. But
absolutely. And I think also they say that the protein, because I think the question is about protein over here. Majorly, I think they also say, "Ma'am, you are the master." I'm just saying that what I've heard, that there is a certain grams that you should calculate with your body weight. That if your body weight is, let's say, 100, then there is some calculation that you should only have this much of grams of protein, which is sufficient for you. If you do take it more than that, it's, I think, something on those lines, ma'am. Anything on if you can just
actually, na, all these calculations you cannot. I mean, you cannot trust on them because after going in the system, after going in the digestive system, what happens to that is very important. As I said, you are not what you eat. Just if you are eating those many grams and if it is not digested, then what is the use? So there are so many biochemical reactions which are taking place in the body, which will be helping in the digestion, assimilation of the food. And therefore, it is not like 2 + 2 = 4. That equation doesn't work here. Everyone's body chemistry is different. See, I started my talks with the topic chemistry in the kitchen.
Yes.
So there I always used to tell that every individual is different. And everyone has unique body chemistry. So accordingly, that food will be digested and assimilated. So there is no hard and fast. You have to just eat dal chawal, jo apna system hai, jo jaise aapke ghar mein ho. Vaise hi tarah se khaoge, to aapko barabar se nutrients, protein sab mil jayega.
Ma'am, ab hum baat kar rahe the ki proteins ke bare mein. Now the question is if you must take protein daily, but due to protein, if level of uric acid increases and it results in joint pain, then what to do?
Actually, uric acid increases mainly because of the lifestyle, that is lack of exercise, no enough sleep, that will lead to uric acid. And if you are vegetarian particularly, then because of those vegetarian sources of proteins, your uric acid will not increase much.
Okay.
And therefore you can have it safely, but you have to look after your lifestyle first. Bed time is very important here. At what time you are going to sleep?
Adivam, you said it very rightly when you said that there's a process that, you know, that our body goes through in a certain specific time of the day.
So that is.
Because I read somewhere that you should be in the bed fast asleep before 10 o'clock because there's a 10 o'clock, the body goes through in a certain process place which doesn't take place after that.
Yeah.
And just
that is why in Marathi, aise bolte, laukar nize, laukar uthe, tayar arogya dhana sampatti bhete. Then only you can get your health.
Yes. No, because I just, this is the two cents of thing I want to add over here. I used to earlier sleep at 12 and then get up at 7 o'clock. That used to be my normal pattern. But then from past 1 year, what I've done is I've started sleeping at 9:30 and getting up at 4:30 or 5 in the morning.
Wow, that's great.
The same number of hours, yeah. But the duration is the same. But I think the energy level is much, much higher than what I used to have.
Yes, you rightly said it. So I think everyone who is listening should follow this.
Yeah, it does make a lot of difference, ma'am. It does make a lot of difference. Ma'am, the question you said about the raisins, that for the iron we should dip it the black raisins and have it in the morning. Is it also good for the people who are suffering from diabetic?
Yes, they can have.
Okay, any number of raisins, 5 or 6 or?
5 to 8.
5 to 8 is a good enough number.
And they will also help for smooth periods also for ladies particularly.
Okay.
Chetan, there is a question. There is a question relating to thyroid. Lady judges.
Where is it, sir?
It was dismissed.
Okay, that's right. I think that was a part of the same. So that was the same thing. So diabetics, there was another thing. Many lady judges suffer from thyroid and PCOD problems. Ma'am, can you please guide us on these issues?
Okay, so those who are having this thyroid and PCOD issues, they should have halim, aliu in Marathi, halim in Hindi, and garden cress seeds in English. Okay, so they have to eat halim ka laddu daily, or the another alternative is you can just take about say 10 to 15 garden cress seeds and add to milk and have it after some time, because when you add to the milk they get soaked. And I will ask them to read Arujuta's book on especially PCOD and hypothyroid. She has written a book, so they can refer to that book and they will get all the information which is required.
Yes. I think it's a vast topic.
Training is also required for PCOD thyroid strength training, though not now it is possible, but after unlocking you can have all the ladies and just can go for strength training. You have to do it at least twice, if not possible twice, do at least once in a week. I will tell my own experience. I mean not PCOD, hypothyroid, etc., but after 60 years of my age, मुझे ऐसे थोड़ा लग रहा था कि थोड़े muscles weak हो रहे हैं क्या, थोड़ा ऐसा feeling आ रहा था. So Rujuta advised me to do strength training. So I was little bit I was not very comfortable going to the gym and do strength training, but I did it and then actually my strength increased. Now I'm almost at 70 and I'm going everywhere for talks and doing everything, whatever is possible. Give your muscles get strengthened. So actually aging mein kya hota hai? Muscles, they lose their strength. So muscles should be having good strength.
Like Yelagar sir said in the starting that ma'am is in her 60s, but she doesn't look like 60 because of her yoga and everything. So I think this is very important. This is very, very important, ma'am. Ma'am, we also talked about the utensils, like iron utensils, vessels should be used. And then we spoke about that why we should not use aluminium, because it takes the place of zinc. Is there any other utensils or vessel that you should be used for cooking?
It's one important vessel which you should not use, non-stick vessels.
Okay. Oh my God.
Non-stick vessels. Why you should not? Because I'm sure that all of your
everyone
are smiling. You are using them only. So instead of them, you have to use iron ka, or you can use pital ka. Pital ka jo brass vessels aate, usme aapko banana chahiye. Kyunki ye jo non-stick vessels hai, they are lined from inside with Teflon. And this Teflon is not good for our health. And what happens is when we are using them, we take a lot of care. We use wooden spatula, then we use liquid soap, etc. But still, what will happen? the layer will start coming out. Initially you will see a small white line, but we will not discard it because we are not Westerns. Use and throw policy nahi hai hamari. We will keep using them till it becomes completely white. Okay, so where all the Teflon has gone, the Teflon has gone into our system. And there are no enzymes to digest Teflon. Isn't it? So we cannot use. And another thing which you should avoid is microwave oven. Why you should avoid? Because when you are using microwave oven, you are heating that food suddenly. I mean, the temperature rises in 30 seconds. And the nutrient molecules are so delicate that they get broken up because of the sudden heat, particularly vitamins. And therefore, even if you are making it yourself, cooking it yourself, and if you are heating in microwave oven, you are converting it into junk food.
So am I right if I understand that by discarding the aluminium vessels and by adopting these coating vessels, Teflon coated, we have in fact invited more troubles.
Why these vessels were introduced, non-stick vessels? Because we thought that fats are bad for health. But now you know that fats are very good for health, for our brain, for our joints, for everything. Fats are required. So why to use non-stick wares?
I know. And we get so excited when we see that line says Teflon coating. We're like, okay, it's Teflon coating. Let's go for it. Okay, ma'am, I think we have a lot of questions. I'll just get to the next one. Ma'am, you were very categorically, you mentioned this thing, and I made a note of it as well, that we should not have curd from the market.
Yes.
And rather we should have curd made at home for obvious reasons, because the bacteria is active. Now, the question is that, what is the proper method to make a curd at home?
Oh.
I know it actually.
See, suppose you are taking this much milk in this. Make it warm. Slightly you have to heat it. It should be warm. And then make chas of the curd, which you are already having. And then just add one drop. ओके हमने तुमको देखा बस इतना ही वन ड्रॉप डालने का ज्यादा नहीं और देन यू हैव टू स्टर इट प्रॉपरली फॉर अबाउट 50 टाइम्स लाइक दिस एंड देन यू विल गेट गुड कर्ड इन द मॉर्निंग इफ यू सेट इन द इवनिंग यू विल बी गेटिंग द कर्ड एट नाइट यू सेट फॉर द नेक्स्ट मॉर्निंग एक्चुअली आई एम थिंकिंग ऑफ मेकिंग वन वीडियो I think I have made also of making curd because many people don't know how to make properly the curds. And everyone from your home also should learn out because it is the simplest thing that you can have.
Yes, yes. Ma'am, move to the next question. Anti-constipation diet.
Someone wants huge lot of weight. Use lot of ghee in your diet.
Lot of ghee.
Ghee.
Okay.
Ghee. Smoothening ho jata hai usse.
Yes.
Intestines will. Then, if you are using just dals, use wo chilke ke saath jo dal hoti hai, wo use karo. Khichdi banane ke liye, wo chilke wali moong dal le lo.
Yeah.
Usse hoga. You have to use curds. You can have beet also, cooked beet. If you eat and then green vegetables also, all these things. And then when you are eating those black raisins now, and if they are with seeds, they will also help. You can have fig, anjeer, fig, and dried fig.
Yeah.
That also you have to soak overnight and have it in the morning.
Yeah, in the morning, yes. And so I think
that will be anti-constipation diet.
And healthy as well.
Yes.
Ma'am, I think this is again, a lot of people have this green tea, normal tea. Should we have tea? Should we have coffee? So the question is, should we restrict consuming tea?
I mean, see, in the morning after getting up, it should not be the first thing. The first thing should be with nutrients, because after all, it is not going to give you any nutrients as such. And therefore, have these raisins and badam or akrod or cashew, whatever it is, after half an hour you can have your tea. In the, see, the important thing is the first thing you should not have, and don't replace any meal by tea. That is, if you are very hungry, say at about 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the evening, then don't just drink tea and biscuits and suppress your hunger. Because many people have tea to suppress the hunger, so that should not be done. And avoid packaged foods, avoid biscuits.
Can you see something happening on the screen right now? 2 to 3 cups
in a day will be fine, not more than that.
Can you see something happening on the screen right now? Someone is laughing so much with everything that you're saying. I think Yalagra sir is.
Yeah, I am accustomed to that. That's why I got it in now. Yes. Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Yes.
Ma'am, I think they also said that you should have, you know, without even brushing your teeth, you should have empty stomach. You should have water. It cleanses your organs, everything.
Your morning job is done easily. Therefore, you should have that. But don't add anything to it. Because again, now there is a fashion pad, you can say. Add cinnamon powder, add moringa powder. Those things don't work like that. What is superfood? When it is taken along with other foods, I mean, if you are using moringa, then it should be in your dal, it should be in your sabji, in your paratha, and not just warm water.
Okay. Ma'am, in Marathi, we call, there's a word chuna. There's a thing, chuna, as it known as in Marathi. Yes. And it is called as the source of calcium.
Yeah,
how do you use it in a daily diet?
Add to the curry.
Okay. That's the straightforward, easy answer.
Yeah.
And ma'am, you said that, you know, everywhere, like you said, in northern we have rajma, then in other areas we have rajma chawal, and other places we have chawal. The question is whether rice should be avoided if anyone is having high or abdominal sugar levels.
No, it should not be avoided. But what? How we eat rice? We don't just eat just rice, but along with it we take dal. Then we also have ghee on it. We also add lemon on it, and that is why the glycemic index will not be high of this meal. If you just take rice, it is different. But when you are eating rice along with either curd or with all these, what I told, or you can have even achar. So when you have all this complete meal of rice, dal, nimbu, ghee, or rice, curd, achar, then the glycemic index of that meal will not be high. It will be less only. So diabetic patients can also have it.
Okay. Ma'am, now because we're talking about packaged food a lot nowadays, the question is that, how to know whether which product are good when we opt for to buy liquid rich in vitamin C? Example, like when we say Chyawanprash comes with sugar, you know, apart from vitamin C, it also comes with sugar. So how to assure which product are actually good in acids and having good source of vitamin?
Now, see, for Chyawanprash, sugar must be added, because otherwise it will not be formed only. It will not be, otherwise sugar is acting as preservative here. So it is necessary. And now I cannot take here the name of any brand, but that you have to look that which brand is good. And if possible, you can make just amla murabba at home. As I told on my Instagram, I have also given that recipe of amla murabba. Yesterday only I have posted amla sharbat ka recipe. So that is also very good. And packaged food, any packaged food is bad, because they contain two harmful groups of chemicals. One is grass. Grass is generally regarded as safe. okay, they are not giving you the name of the chemical, but they just mention it with some random number. You will always see that on the packet, you can see one random number which is written, which is a type of grass molecule. And they also contain HFCS, high fructose corn sugar. It is not our cane sugar. And that is why any packaged food is bad.
Yes.
जितना पैकेट फूलेगा रुजुता से यानी जितना पैकेट खुलेगा उतना पेट फूलेगा ऐसा वो बोलते हैं हमेशा
पेट फूलने पे मुझे एक क्वेश्चन सामने दिख रहा है बड़ा अच्छा क्वेश्चन है पेट फूलने पे ही द क्वेश्चन इज दैट जजेस सेज दैट यू नो दे बिकॉज़ ऑफ देयर लाइफस्टाइल दे आर सिटिंग थ्रू आउट द डे लाइक एंड लाइक यू सेड इट्स इम्पॉसिबल फॉर देम टू गेट अप एंड डू एवरीथिंग
या
So how can they, what diet they should adopt to reduce the tummy because they can't avoid sitting for a long time?
Ma'am, I will add the three more for common questions also here. As I said, as Chetan said, I was laughing when you were saying that tea and biscuit should not be substitute for the lunch, etc. Same is the question, main question for all of our judges. So if instead of that tea and biscuit are what would be the good or sustainable food during that noon time, you know, only we will be having hardly 10 or 15 minutes to have our food, you know, even at the end of the time, the lawyer will say, sir, sir, only 5 minutes, sir, bas pass, bas ye my sir case khatam kar deta hu main. So judge, theek hai, convenient hai, so apna sacrifice kar deta hai isme. He will give his 10 to 15 minutes. फिर बचे कुछ है, फिर वो 50 मिनट भी नहीं है उसमें हार्डली, तो क्या डाइट उसमें हो सकता है, ये कॉमन क्वेश्चन है यहाँ पर.
तो उसमें ना आप शरबत लीजिए.
ओके.
हाँ, शरबत, एनी शरबत यू कैन कैरी, सी लेमन नींबू शरबत है, बेल शरबत है, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन वेयर यू आर, नेचुरल.
Yeah.
Everything should be natural. Then अमृत कोकम जो बोलते हैं, have you heard about अमृत कोकम?
Yeah, yeah, yes, yes, yes.
Yeah. So it is actually like acts like amrut. So that is why amrut kokam le sakte hai. In month of April, you can have aam ka panha.
Yeah.
You can have mogra sharbat also. There are so many sharbats which are made at home, and then you can carry or chas carry karo. Ghar mein banayo chas, and then you can carry dry fruits. You can carry cashews. Few cashews you can have. You can have rajgira ka laddu. Just ek dal do. See, I want to tell you the importance of rajgira. Do you know rajgira ka laddu aata hai? Abhi uske jo teen naam hai, wo sunke aapko bahut acha lagega. Rajgira matlab it is a grain of king.
Yeah.
In Hindi, it is Ram Dana. It is king. Grain of God. And English, amaranthus. So this amar is also a word which is Sanskrit mein jo living long, longevity dikhata hai. So rajgira is very good. So you can just carry rajgira laddu or ragi ka laddu. I say three R's are very important. Rajgira, ragi and rice.
That's good. That's easy. Ma'am, I think the time is, we're running short of time. I'll just quickly get to the other questions. Ma'am, what is the best time to have curd? Then there's a similar question. What is the best time to have milk?
Depends upon individual. I will tell you milk, for example. I will give my example. In the morning, if I have milk, I just cannot digest. But at night, I can have a full glass of milk and I can easily digest after the dinner. So that lactose sensitivity is there in the morning, but at night somehow it disappears. So now curd also, many people say that curd at night, if they have, they get sardi, khasi, etc.
Yes.
But we people are having curd morning, evening. So you look after, see, it is very important to study your own body pattern. Ki mujhe kya hota hai? Ye khane se mujhe achha lagta hai kya? Ye khane se कुछ बिगड़ता है क्या? So it is better to avoid that. So there is no fixed hard and fast rule that don't have milk in the morning or don't have milk at night, don't have, there is no rule as such, but follow your own body ka pattern.
Yeah, know your body, basically that's what you're saying.
Yes.
And it doesn't matter, you should have a curd with sugar or salt.
Doesn't matter.
It's just personal choice.
Yeah.
I think a few members are asking for a sample diet chart. I think we will talk about that. Probably a, you know, ma'am's book would be a better option.
Yeah.
This session would be too short for a sample diet chart.
Yes.
The question is, what is the nexus between food and cholesterol? Meaning, which food to be avoided so to maintain body cholesterol in limit?
See, body requires cholesterol. That is the first thing. Cholesterol is not bad at all. And only living beings can produce cholesterol. So it is a misconception that cashews contain cholesterol. See, why we are told that don't eat cashews because they will increase your cholesterol? Because cashews are from developing countries like us and Africa. While we are always told that you can have badam, you can have akrod, but don't have cashews. But cashews, they don't produce cholesterol. And now our Goans, they have started having the packet with the label, no cholesterol, zero cholesterol. So this is completely misconception. Only you have to avoid certain non-vegetarian foods. Nothing vegetarian you can.
I have one question. I have picked up one question. I said since our members, family members are also attending.
Last question.
Last question, but it will cover many of the participants.
Okay.
the question is, children and elders, what can be said to be the balanced foods for children and elders? And which things contain vitamin B12?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. See, what I will tell you, no? Whatever young people require, the same thing is required by children and elders. See, when the practice should be, whatever you cook at home, the same food should be given to your children. The only thing, it should be in less quantity and softer version. It should be thoroughly cooked. The same thing is true for elders also who don't have proper chewing, no teeth or something of that sort. They require also in less quantity and it should be properly cooked. If it is kacha, not children and elders will not be able to digest. But the food remains basically the same. There will not be any change because the same nutrients are required.
Yes.
And what about B12? You can have B12 in milk and milk products as well as all the fermented foods and sprouts will be having B12.
So, with as ma'am said, that shall be the last question. ma'am, just I will.
I
take
think most of the questions are covered, na Chetan?
Yes.
Ma'am,
yes.
A lot. I think the question will keep on coming up, but I think
broadly, ma'am, you have covered almost all the aspects. You have enlightened us in this time of a very needy hour, and you have covered a vast group, and they will spread up this message. You know, not only this is for them, they will spread up this message for others also. On behalf of all my brothers and sisters who have attended this session today, and on behalf of the academy, I express my gratitude and thanks to you for giving your valuable time. And
it's my honor, sir.
And we will again trouble you, ma'am. It will be all. Yes,
I'm ready to take the trouble.
yes. Thank you very much.
Because it is giving me joy and not trouble.
And I express thanks to the SCC Online management also who have been in collaboration with us for these webinars. And you know, this is also kind of jugaad we are doing. Our academy is not having.
So how many members attended?
Ma'am, 325 on YouTube. Yes, Chetan, can you tell the figure here?
So right now, the last time I checked, there were approximately 240 members were here.
Ah.
But I'll get the exact number once the webinar is over. I'll take the attendance report and then I'll get the exact numbers.
Ma'am, we have to multiply all these numbers by at least 3 times.
Yeah, family members, yes.
Yeah, because common, yes, yes.
I have a confession to make.
Yeah.
While I was running my iPad next to myself, my father was walking around in the house and I'm like, Dad, you're doing something. He's like, no, I take my iPad, just watch this. And he was glued. So I got 2 things done. My ensuring that my YouTube is working, and he got the information. And he personally, he just came over here and I went offline for a moment. He said, just pass my regards to ma'am. It's a wonderful session.
Thank you.
I'm sure, ma'am, a lot of people have been giving the comments like that.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much. And we have also shared the link to your Instagram, ma'am. I'm already connected. And
I have a request. Please keep this link open in the YouTube. Many of the members who could not see it want to watch it. Sir, please keep the YouTube.
I was just coming to that, sir. This video is getting recorded. So we'll be sending a copy of this to Maharashtra Judicial Academy. And if sir would like to do it over there, they can do it. Otherwise, this live is already on YouTube. And I will also be uploading this video as a separate video, not as a live video, but separate video on SEC Online YouTube channel. So anyone can go and rerun this as and when they want it.
Ma'am,
I think we'll not take much of your time. We'll take an extra time. Thank you so much. And we are really in debt because of this. Thanks to all your wisdom that you shared with us.
Thanks. My pleasure.
Yelagra, sir, thank you so much.
You.
And we will meet everyone in the next webinar. Thank you. Yeah. Take care.